What's up, y'all? D Fire, and I'm just so confused with this fucking Louisiana fucking weather. It was just storming, now the sun trying to come out. What the fuck? I'm so tired of this weather. I just want consistency. That's all I want. Consistent weather, whether it's gonna be hot as fuck or cold as hell. Well, maybe not cold as hell, but you know, cold as a fucking polar bear's pussy, I guess. I don't fucking know. You walk outside in the morning, sunshine. By 10 o'clock, it's fucking raining. By 3 in the afternoon, it's fucking hot again. By 4:30, it's fucking chilly as fuck. Fucking weather's more bipolar than I am. The bitch needs some Lexapro. Excuse me. Anyway, y'all, I'm doing, another reaction. Krizz Kaliko, I'm trying to get used to saying his name right. Krizz Kaliko, Stop the World. When I hear this, Stop the World, that made me think of, pick the world up and drop it on your fucking head. It made me think of Lil Wayne, but, you know, we're gonna listen to this one. This is 5 minutes and 57 seconds long. So let's get on into it. Yo, this is already starting off kind of fucking depressing. If this makes me cry, I ain't gonna do shit. I'ma just cry.
Look upon my face, defines the room.
I did not know this nigga could sing though. Like, I mean, I was listening to Scars and shit, but I did not really know this nigga could sing. And before I listened to that song, like, I just thought the nigga could rap, man. These niggas is getting all kind of fucking versatile and being all fucking spread out and shit. That's what's up.
There's so much I want to say that I hide from you. And it's obvious it hurts. I can make it worse, but I know my limits. Show me a Bible verse, cause I don't want to search, just want to end it. It's so hard for me to pray. Why I sit and wait in a line for change? And maybe you'll relate if you've ever played a waiting game. Now my life is like a merry-go-round, sick and ready to stop now. I can't handle this speed. Stop the world and let me off.
Y'all, this is so relatable, yeah. Y'all, like 2 years ago, I was going through some rough shit, some real rough shit in my life. And I tried to end it twice. I mean, that wasn't even the first time that I've tried to kill myself. I tried to kill myself, shit, many times since I was 13. And that's just, like, you see, and it wasn't that I wanted to die. Is what he exactly what he just said, stop the world and let me off. I just didn't want to do it anymore. I just wanted to not be in that situation or in that predicament anymore. I just wanted to be like off of that. Like, I just wanted to be in a different mind frame, a different setting. Just that ride, that roller coaster I was on was just, it was rough. It was real rough. And I'm doing so much better now. I mean, granted, I might have to be on medication for life because my highs are high, but my lows are really, really, really low. So I can definitely understand and relate to this song. Sometimes you just want it all to stop and you just can't do it no more. Or you just don't want to try, you want to have to even try to do it anymore. You just need a break. So understandable, dog.
Stop the world and let me out. Stop the world and let me out. Let me out. Please stop the world. Let me out. Let me out. And I got the nerve to try to smile. Ain't been happy for a while. I only laugh to hide my pain. And I got nothing left to give. This ain't no way for me to live. To get to the sun, gotta go through the rain. It's so hard for me to pray. Why I sit and wait in a line for change? And maybe you relate if you've ever played the waiting game. Now my life is like a merry-go-round. Sick and ready to stop now.
I like that, Doug. I like how they have taken there, like, you know. And that's how it need to be. Like, no matter what, y'all, if we see somebody that's in need, we should be able to help them. But we're not all built like that, bro. Like, I got a thing for, like, people that's really homeless. Not, like, the ones that pretend to be homeless. Like, the ones that's really fucking homeless. The ones I know that's homeless for a fact. Like, when I worked at Walmart, there was this, like, this dude. I worked there for, like, at that one particular Walmart. I worked there for, like, a year and a half. Something like that. And this dude, that whole time I worked there, this dude was always outside. So I would always either buy him a bag of chip or go work to, when I would be leaving, I would go to the Burger King or the McDonald's and get him a little meal and stuff. And he'd be so grateful, like, you know, if I had any change left over, you know, from what I had, my bills and my bus fare and my cigarettes at the time, you know, I would give him like $5. Here, go get you something to drink, go get you something to eat. Something, you know, it's better than nothing, you know. And when I didn't have it, he understood because he knew if I had it, I would give it to him. You know what I'm saying? And sometimes I'd be like the only one actually giving this man money, like, you know what I'm saying? And I like that, you know, each and every one of them, they was having bad days. They was having fucked up days. And they gave this man some change. I know it's just a video, but sometimes in real life it really do be like that, you know. Like, especially when I worked at Walmart, I could be having the most fucked up day in the whole fucking world. But if I knew just my little gesture of being nice enough to give somebody some change for them to get a meal or just a snack or just something to drink that would change their whole day, then, you know, I feel good about it. You know, I didn't want nothing in return. Maybe that's just why I fucked up in life. I'm too fucking nice. Some people take my kindness for weakness.
Can't handle this speed. Stop the world and let me off. Stop the world and let me off. Stop the world and let me off.
I've been there, like, thinking, what am I gonna do now? You know, this was it. You know, what am I gonna fucking do now? Man, this shit hurts.
Let me off.
A message to the mentally disturbed. Don't kill yourself or anyone else. Stay here with us. Your time to shine is coming. Trust.
I'm glad I listened to the rest of the song because it was actually getting a little bit too much for me. But, and you know, what Tech said is true. You know, don't kill yourself. Your time to shine is coming. Because, y'all, what if I would have succeeded in killing myself those two times? Like, 2 years ago, I wouldn't be able to see my daughter grow up, bruh. My daughter is fucking amazing. She's so beautiful. She's so smart. That's my little angel, man. That's my little princess. And had I taken myself from her, how would she feel when she grew up and knew what that's what the fuck happened to her mom? You know? And I also wouldn't be in the space I'm in now, y'all. Cause I swear, like, I hated my last job. I was a custodian, y'all, at a fucking school, and I hated that job. I did it because I had a daughter to take care of. I had rent to pay, I had bills to pay, I needed, you know. Now I'm like, fuck, I don't have to work. I just finished school, I got a driver's license now. I'm not shining yet, but I'm doing so much better. Had I taken my life then, I wouldn't know what any of this feels like. All right, y'all, now I'm going to cry for a little while because this song really it hit home for me. So I'm going to holler at y'all later. Deuces.